down from his absolute fury. He was going to go and punch Nick, and I had to try and stop him from punching Nick.
The phone call I got was from a producer who was virtually hysterical. Let's just calm down and think about it. Sleep on it, and we'll do it in the morning.
We're going to have a meeting in the morning.
Why?
Just everyone's upset over all various things.
And it's generally the girls who aren't happy.
This occasion, Nick, I'm not very happy.
Aren't you?
No.
I didn't know that. Did you go to diary room?
I did, yeah. They just told me to bring it up at the table, wait till everybody's around and talk, didn't they?
OK. I look forward to it tomorrow.
Me too.
It was actually a genius decision, because what it meant was we were able to get our act together, cameras were in position, we could look into the whites of his eyes and their eyes, and that's why it was so powerful.
You have sat and blatantly had a one-on-one conversation with me and make arrangements for the future. You know, when we get out of here, I want to ask you, Nick, how can you do that?
We decided that we're going to ask you to leave the house. I'm sorry, Nick, I'm sorry it's come to this, but we have to follow the rules of Big Brother.
I remember leaving the house by the back door and getting into the black Mercedes, but getting into the wrong door because Ruth was there.
I had to tell him that he was the most hated man in Britain, that he'd got devil's horns, and so it was quite a lot for a human being to take in, and he sort of veered from being very scared and upset to being like, how much money will I make? I remember Davina was called at 6 o'clock in the morning to come out to do the interview.
For me, it was probably the biggest moment of my career. There'd never been so much interest. I mean, it was all cloak and dagger. I was kind of frightened the paparazzi were going to be following my car, and I wasn't thinking straight. Anyway, I didn't have my makeup with me.
So she went to a massive Tesco's nearby, bought 2 pairs of pants, because I haven't got any underwear to change into, and some makeup, which would have been a press story in its own right, Davina, 6 a.m. buying makeup and underwear. And she brought it to the hotel, and we did the interview.
Hello, Nick. How are you feeling?
I felt like I was interviewing Genghis Khan. You know, it was like a huge, serious moment. And I'm a light entertainment presenter. How am I going to deliver?
How did you feel when the group confronted you? Because that was an extreme moment.
I'll give you an answer in a second.
It was an awful interview. It was terrible. He was so wary and scared, I suppose. It was like getting blood out of a stone.
You haven't sort of actually actively said you're sorry yet, are you?
Oh, yes, yeah. I'm very sorry for it.
If he'd been in the American version of the show, he'd have been a hero, not a villain, because that's how the show's always been played in America. The people who manipulate the rules are voted the winners. Only in strangely moral Britain could somebody who played the game show to its full extent be marked down.
So that's the end of the beginning, but the Big Brother story just gets bigger. In part two, we'll find out how more genius decisions, luck and controversy...
He was so boring.
...projected Big Brother into the heart of the nation's televisions, press and mobile phone bills.
We're in a whole grey area with this kind of forecast.
The confrontation was watched by more than 6 million TV viewers.
Get really excited on the net because you can chat to other people at the same time.
When you have real people involved in real drama...
No one expected Big Brother to take off in the way it did.
It was omnipresent. Everywhere I went, people wanted to discuss it with me.
I found the press side terrifying because it was just beyond our control. You know, my mobile phone would ring and they go, hi, morning, it's blah blah radio and you're live on radio. And I'd be thinking, oh my God, put the phone down thinking, shit.
Going to the supermarket would take 4 hours because every single aisle I went down, I'd have to have another discussion about Big Brother.
I'd be on a train that very first summer and people would be talking about Big Brother and my ears would prick up, and then they'd start impersonating me, day five in the Big Brother house, giggle, giggle. Oh my God, that's me.
the huge crowds that we could house at Bow were so exciting.
It's just brilliant how involved people get. It was nerves, and it was excitement, and it was adrenaline. It was like a huge rave. It was like that kind of just give me a glow stick and a whistle and I'm off.
Big Brother revolutionised the way we watch TV and how the press reported on it.
Big Brother was an almost instant hit with a younger generation of viewers, people in their teens and early 20s. Heat capitalised on that very cleverly.
At the beginning of 2000, Heat was the most famous magazine flop in Britain. Essentially, we were given that summer to save the magazine.
Everything changed with the second eviction from Series 1.
Andrew was about to rejoin the outside world.
We didn't have anyone else that week. So it was like, OK, let's dummy up a cover with him on there. And I remember looking at the screen and going, but he's not famous, he's not a celebrity. It seemed like the oddest cover in the world. It was a huge seller for us. And it changed everything about Heat. As soon as that sale came in, we were away.
Big Brother is back, bigger and tougher than before.
Anticipation was intense when Series 2 began, and the producers hoped for new, dramatic storylines. But instead of nasty, they got nice.
You can't make these things that happen. So Nick was Series 1, Paul and Helen Series 2, you know.
I don't know why they chose me, really. I think perhaps they chose me because they thought I might have been a bit of a dizzy blonde, which I still am. We could sleep in here, can we?
It's a really bad idea.
Paul was the one that we weren't sure of, and he was so boring. We interviewed him 7-8 times, willing him to tell us a funny story. Or he was a nice lad, but he was dull. And we sent him in thinking he'll be the first out, he'll just bore everyone. Probably never forgive me for saying that, but he was young.
We're on top of her.
Helen just sort of fell for him immediately. Now, we hadn't had this in Series 1. This was kind of new. There wasn't this whole sex thing going on, the pressure to have sex or who was going to have sex first and did they have sex, and all of this focus on sex wasn't there yet. So I was still allowed to fully enjoy this sweet romance, and that's why I think I was so captivated by it, because I believed it.
Helen and Paul's love affair gripped viewers and sent the press pack into overdrive.
When Paul got evicted, we had to hide him away in a hotel. We thought a newspaper was going to get a hold of Big G, bring him up to London, and they have a fight, and it'd be flash, flash, flash. They'd get their scoop, and it would ruin our buy-up. So we had to, like, hide him away for 3 days. I felt so sorry for the guy, because he'd been stuck in that house, and then he had to be locked up in a hotel with me.
Audiences loved it, the media loved it, and Channel 4 wanted more.
I got a call from Andrew Newman at Channel 4 and said, look, I've had this idea. It's like a daily strip show about Big Brother. And I was like, I don't know if I want to do a show about Big Brother all day. And he said, yes, but it's live. And that was hand up. I just wanted to do live television. Hello, welcome to Big Brother's Little Brother. It's only day 7, ladies and gentlemen, and already there have been fireworks. And I ain't talking about sparklers. I'm talking about Catherine Wheels.
I never thought that many people would be interested in it. That's a strange thing.
I genuinely didn't think that people who watch the main show would be that turned on by a daily strip show. I just didn't think we'd have the legs.
Series 2's winner, Brian Dowling, burst out of the house and straight into television fame. And that changed things.
With Series 3, I think it was harder to cast because the people that were coming forward to be in Big Brother were of a type, and they wanted to be famous and they wanted their 15 minutes of fame and a cover on Heat magazine.
But one of the new housemates just seemed happy to be away from her mum for a bit.
She, from the very outset,
even amongst the team, divided opinions. Some people thought, my God, she should never go into the Big Brother house. She's just too much. And some people